I'm Brooke Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii. Welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii. I'm your host, Brooke Lee, and I'm here at one of my favorite places on the planet, Waialii Kitchen and Bake Shop in Manoa. Especially during these hard times, Hawaii, we have to support local businesses, and what better place than someplace that's naturally social distanced? The food is divine, and you kind of need just something that makes you feel relaxed in these times, you know, because COVID has made a lot of businesses have to sort of pivot. And we're looking for answers to questions. So we decided to check in with Dr. Jill Green, who's the CEO of Queen's Hospital. She sits on the Hawaii COVID Collaborative. Take a look. Hey, everybody. We're socially distanced, but I'm very excited because I am here with Dr. Jill Green, who is the president and CEO of the Queen's Health System. Good morning, Dr. Green. How are you?
Aloha, and thank you for inviting me to be with you this morning.
So Dr. Green, do you want to tell us about the Hawaii COVID Collaborative and COVID POW?
Wonderful, I appreciate you asking. This is such an important time in our community as we're all facing this pandemic and all of us are learning. And the Hawaii COVID Collaborative really was created by the Hawaii State Legislature's House Senate Committee on COVID. And they had a special committee on communications and strategy. And in that, there were several representatives of healthcare leaders around the community, as well as legislators. And from that, we kept thinking about how could we actually help everyone understand. There's lots of data. And as a nurse of 40 years, I'm used to looking at lots of data and translating it. But when it comes to this, and we're trying to protect our ohana, we're trying to protect our neighbors, we're trying to make sure that our businesses work, we need to be able to understand and translate that data into what does it mean for me? So COVID POW was a development that occurred by many members that were in that committee with private businesses and not-for-profits donating monies to start the website where we could share the information and then bring the stories. Because for most of us, when we talk story, that's when we learn. And what you'll see on the site is information, data, but what I find to be so touching my heart is listening to the stories of individuals that have had COVID and what that journey looked like for them and their ohana. What it looked like if you lost a loved one to this very devastating disease, and how people are living with being in our community and doing all the things that keep us safe and living and continuing to have a joyful, engaged life. So we're all trying to figure that out together.
Amazing. So do you want to talk to us a little bit about how Queen's Health System is fitting into all of this and where your guys' heart lie in the whole collaborative?
As you know, Queen's is deeply dedicated to making sure that we care for everyone. And through this journey, we have cared for the majority of individuals with COVID. So if we look at our legacy and Queen Emma and King Kamehameha, they started our hospital, our original hospital, when they were facing a pandemic. So for us, it goes to the heart and soul of who we are. We are privileged to have great partners. As you look at our HPH and Adventist and all the health systems, we've all been working together. And I was so appreciative of the speaker who invited the health systems into this conversation. So for us, Queens believes that our job is not only to take care of you when you're ill, we want to help you stay well. So we're spending a tremendous amount of time focusing on how can we help you and your ohana right now prevent the illness, prevent the spread, be able to live a healthy life during this pandemic. So for us, the collaborative created a much larger group to help share stories, to put the data together, and ensure that you're hearing a message that's not just Queens, it's coming from multiple health systems, multiple partners, but very centered on, for a Queens, it always has to be the highest quality care and it has to be science-based. So you're hearing a trusted source of information and many partners. All are working together to make sure that we're doing the right thing.
You know, we're going into this next phase, right? We're introducing tourism back into the state. A lot of people are nervous. They're starting to let kids go back to school slowly in waves. Do you have any sort of recommendations for how people can sort of mitigate this? Because I know we're all taking a collective breath and wondering what's going to happen next.
One of the things, as a nurse of 40 years, we can control this disease, and it starts with our own personal behaviors. So there is no more important time, and I can't emphasize this enough. If you wear your mask, if you are physically distancing, that and you are washing your hands, and I'll add getting your flu shot, You substantially reduce the risk of transmission of this disease, whether it's getting it or sharing it. To see how everyone comes together to protect their ohana, to protect each other, to work together, we can do this. But we need to make sure that we have to be vigilant. We do not let that down right now.
Well, thank you again so much for being on the show and sharing all of that wonderful information. I promise you, I'm going to wear my mask, wash my hands, and stay away from people. Thanks so much, Dr. Green.
Thank you.
I'm here with Becky Stichetti, who is the executive director of HIF. Hi, Becky.
Hi, Brooke.
Let's take our masks off because we're socially distanced. How are you?
I'm so good. Thank you so much for having me on your show.
I'm a big fan of the Hawaii International Film Festival and happy 40th anniversary.
Thank you.
You know, we're focusing on how a lot of events have had to pivot. We're calling it a pivot. And none other than the biggest pivot, which is a film festival where you used to bring in rock stars from all over the planet to our little island, had to change this year. Do you want to talk about that?
We did have to change a lot. Obviously, 2020 has been an enormously difficult year for HIF. But I am so proud of our incredible team and our members and our audience and our partners and sponsors, because they have really rallied behind us and we have been able to completely restructure what we do to offer a reinvented festival this year for the HIF's 40th anniversary.
Going virtual, as sad as it is not to be able to have people come here and celebrate, you're opening up a whole new world for even local filmmakers, right?
So, exactly, and that's part of like the silver lining and what is so exciting about what we're doing. You know, in August, we launched our Summer Fest online to try out the new platform and provide our audiences with some films because we had to skip spring showcase. And we also did our HIF at Home program in March and April, and they were so wildly popular. And what shocked me and my team was that they were so wildly popular with mainland audiences. And we were so excited because for 4 years, you know, when I first started, I started the Made in Hawaii competition program. And the idea was to bring so much more attention and so much more of that spotlight onto the incredible work that's coming out of Hawaii and the Pacific Islands. So we have the Made in Hawaii program and the Pacific Showcase program. I really feel like with our virtual offering this year as part of our hybrid festival, because the festival is a hybrid event and I can talk more about that, but with that virtual offering, we have so many films that are available across the mainland, and we know that there are a ton of people that have lived in Hawaii or have relatives in Hawaii that are on the mainland and crave those authentic stories and want to, you know, keep their finger on the pulse of what's happening here in Hawaii and learn about the incredible culture. And we're able to do that this year in a whole new way, and that is so exciting.
So There's also an opportunity because everybody's hurting right now, obviously, especially the arts in general. And for the 40th anniversary, you guys are actually doing sort of a ability for people to help keep HIF going beyond the next 40. Do you want to talk about that?
Yes, thank you. So this year, as part of our 40th anniversary, we are, of course, celebrating the legacy of the organization and all that we've done over the past 40 years. And we're also celebrating the future of the organization, and part of the online streaming, that's the future. And it's exciting to be forced to do that this year, because it is where we were looking anyways, looking at how does HIF sustain as a vibrant arts offering in Hawaii over the next 40 years. Because of COVID, for the first time in a very long time, we are launching a fundraising campaign. So we're calling it the HIF 40 for 40, and we're hoping to raise $40,000 by the end of the year. It's so easy to donate. You just go to HIF.org, and there's a whole page. As part of it, we're offering a sweepstakes. So we're actually giving away for next year, $120,000 Hawaiian Airline miles and a two-night stay in a suite at Hale Kalani.
Wow.
And some dinner and activities to do while you're in Hawaii. So
right.
These funds really go to supporting HIF as an organization, making sure we can continue our important mission of sharing stories from the world to people in Hawaii, and sharing stories from Hawaii to people in the world as well.
Right.
And every dollar matters right now this year.
Right. Well, congratulations. 40 years is a long run. I mean, that's a very big accomplishment for any film festival, but one that's on a tiny little island in the middle of the ocean during a pandemic. I mean, that's just one level on top of another level on top of another level. Are there any films that you're super excited about that's made it into the lineup this year?
I'm excited about so many of the films. We have over 200 films. So we're actually showing a number of films online. All of them are available to audiences in Hawaii. We have over 150 of those films online available to people across the entire United States. And then we're showing certain films in theaters. So we have an amazing partnership with Consolidated Theaters, who have started to reopen and are following all of the CDC guidelines and state guidelines. We are showing some films in theaters that we're not able to show online,
right,
because they're so big, and these are the films you're going to be hearing about for the Oscars.
Right.
And then we're also launching a drive-in series as well,
which
we're really excited about, Friday and Saturday nights in November, to showcase our incredible local and Pacific Island work.
Wow.
Because this is your opportunity to see those films on a big screen.
Yeah.
And just because of COVID, we don't want to take that away from
the local filmmakers.
The local filmmakers who've worked really hard, and this is their premiere. So we hope you can come out and support those films and filmmakers and teams as well. So I'm excited. Our opening night film is a film called Minari. We're showing it online and in theaters, one night only. It stars Steven Yeun, and it's about a Korean family that immigrates to America, like rural America, and that the whole experience around that. And it's beautiful, and Steven Yeun is breathtaking as usual. So that's one of my favorites. We're showing some films in theaters. I Am Greta, it's a documentary that follows Greta, who's the environmental activist from
right.
Sweden, and she's a teenager and is changing the world, and it's so inspiring.
Well, thanks for being here and
thank
for
you.
All you do. Happy 40th.
Thank you.
And I'm sure it's going to open up a whole new level of entertainment for the local industry especially. So thanks for being here, Becky.
I hope so. Thanks for having me.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii. I'm here with Kumuhula Lemomiho. Hi, Auntie.
Hi, Brooke.
So we're socially distanced. Shall we just uapau with the masks now? We're going to take them off.
Okay, now I can see you.
Yeah. How are you?
Wonderful. Now that I saw you.
I know. It's hard with the masks.
It's so long.
I know.
Too long. Yes.
Well, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
It's so exciting to have you on the show. Let's talk a little bit about the history of halau for you.
Halau, okay. Halau is, our name is Keli'ika Apuni Honua Ke'ena Ohula. And it's to honor my kumu, who I call my mama. And Hiviki I'i Keli'ika Apuni Honua I'i Rodriguez. She is my mentor. She's my kumu, my mama, my best friend, my everything. And so when we decided to carry on her traditions and her legacy, she gave us her name to go forth. And so we try our best and carry her proudly, all that she's left us, tradition-wise, legacy-wise, and that's what we're all about.
And so now, obviously, you know, with the crazy times we're in, everybody's shifted, you know, and adapted. So you were involved with the Prince Lat Hula Festival.
Yes.
You've done it before, but with this year, it's a little different for
yes.
all of us. Do you want to talk about how, you know, the shift was made and how you guys adapted?
Well, first of all, it's an honor. I'm most humbled with the Moana Lua Foundation asking us to be a part of it because it's been so long. And I like that particular festival because it's a sharing. You know, we get to share hula.
Right.
No more stress. Just get
no
out
awards,
there.
No awards, no judging.
Right. Just get out there and hula. And getting the girls ready because we don't have hula now.
Right.
You know, and I don't like Zoom because I want a one-to-one where they're in front of you and you can enjoy them and correct them. And so we haven't had any of that. So in preparing, it was like crash course. They had rehearsal for 2 days, Thursday, Friday. Saturday, boom, was the real thing. But I'm so proud of them. We got through it. We shared our hula. We shared the moment. And I'm happy and proud of them that we did that.
You want to talk a little bit, because we were talking off camera about, you know, the planning of what to perform, because that's always very difficult to pick.
Okay, when they first asked me to do this, I picked the melee, everything. And okay, we were set. I told them, okay, gang, you guys got it. Let's do this. Then it got canceled 3 times, I think.
In and out of lockdown, in
right.
and out of, yeah.
So I think after the second cancellation, then my team mama just went, pow, what you doing? So we come from Palolo, and there is a melee that I did in 1996 at Mary Monarch for Palolo. We found it in an old newspaper, so I took the words and put a melody to it, and we did that as our Kahiko melee. And it was like, you come from Palolo, what are you doing? And it's like, ding! So I called Pauline, I'm so sorry, but last minute change. I hope, you know, it doesn't.
When you have a dream, you gotta honor the dream.
I know, like, mama's telling me, what's wrong with you, girl? So anyway, so we changed everything. And all we did was our tribute to mama, all she shared with us. And then we honored Palolo, where we come from. Mama comes from the valley, and so do I. So I felt, oh, how neat, yeah. Just honor where you come from.
It's your wahipana, you have to.
Everything's right there.
Right.
So that's what we did.
And I heard you guys did it one time, pow.
And I told them, you guys, this is the real thing. You only have one chance. You know, like how we tell them at Miramar, okay, you only have one chance, let's go.
So also, as part of, you know, the whole history, you won the Malia Kau Award.
Oh, I'm so humbled. What an honor to follow in the footsteps of those already above me, you know, because they're all my peers, you know. I'm still learning. I'm still new, I feel, in this business. You know, we learn every day, and I learn from them. So thank you, Moana Lua Foundation, for the honor, for the opportunity. And I am just so humbled. But you know, first of all, we gotta say thank you, Kiakua. You know, he makes all of this happen.
Especially even in the hard times, you have to find the light, right?
And you know, he's there, so we let him guide us, and one day at a time. But I'm just honored and humbled, yes.
So I'm sure people are curious what it was like to be dancing hula, because no one can perform right now. Everybody's, you know, sort of in their own spaces. What was it like to get everybody together and assemble at Queen Emma Summer
you
Palace?
You know, it was really awesome, because all I did, I put out the call and I said, okay, we only could use 8 girls. So I had 7, and I don't like to pick and choose. So I did seniority, you know, that was the easiest way. And
safest.
I said, okay, we're gonna do this. If you can make it, this is what I'm planning to do. Rehearsal at 6, I'll see you there. and they all showed up. So,
but you guys all had your matching masks, and it was just so. Everybody was on point. It was amazing.
No, we were just so happy to see everybody because it's been too long.
It's been long. It's long.
You know, and I'm such a people person. I need them around me, and we've always done things. You know, even when there was no hula, we tried to get together and do stuff just to keep that bond. And oh, I missed them. And so that day was like reunion.
Well, thank you so much for sharing all of your mana'o, and congratulations on the award. Well deserved.
Thank you so much.
And knock on wood, next year everybody all together again.
You know, next year is going to be a better year.
Yeah.
We went through it this long, 3 more months, and it's going to be good.
Yeah.
You just got to be a little bit more patient and take it one day at a time. There's the end of the tunnel. At the end of the year, everything's going to be better.
Yep.
Yeah, but
well, thank you for coming on the show,
Brooke,
Auntie.
Thank you, and thank you for what you do. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you, all the things that you do.
Yes, thank you, thank you.
Mahalo.
Keep up the good work.
Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back. Well, that's our show for today, Hawaii. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I loved this short rib loco moco from Waioli Kitchen and Bake Shop. It's delicious. I highly recommend it. Thank you to them for letting us come down here. And you know, these have been tough times, so we have to support each other. I'm so glad we got to talk with Dr. Jill Green over at Queens Hospital and, you know, get some answers to some of the questions that we have out there during this COVID period. Thank you to Becky Stichetti over at Hawaii International Film Festival. They're really putting a spotlight on local films here, so let's help them out if we can with their 40th campaign, because Hawaii stories should be all over the world if they can. And congratulations to Auntie Leimomi Ho, Kumuhula Extraordinaire, for winning the Malia Kau Award. We're so excited to see what's going on with the Prince Lot Hula Festival this year, because it's virtual and it's going to air right here on KHON and KHI. We're all in this together, Hawaii. Wash your hands, wear those masks, and I'll see you next week.